dish. Give up the dish. Oh, we need the dish. Gotta have that dish.
Bennington is back, and this week's Dish segment is presented by Dish. Tuned in to you. To learn more, call 1-844-CALL-DISH or go to dish.com. And your host of Dish is on vacation, so I'll be your server for the day.
Whoa!
Yes! Whoa! But I do have a special guest. Oh, it's Disco Dan!
Hey, guys!
He likes the dish.
Dan I love dishes. Doing dishes is fun. So, guys, I am so happy to be back for Dish.
It's been a while since we've had you in for a dish.
Oh my gosh, be good.
So let's
used to be gossipy and then you have to stop.
Yeah, you know, there's been a
he took it too far.
Well, he just told me somebody who no longer works here.
Mm-hmm. He always does have the goss.
Yeah, Nick, you didn't know.
No, I didn't. Matter of fact, 37 is like death to me. I don't know who's still there, who's not there. I don't know who's got died. I don't know who's alive, who's dead.
There's a Wild West element to it where, you know, you'll show up and you'll see, oh, there's a desk. I know that name. And then you'll just see the Longhorn Skull.
Wow. These are not allowed to talk about.
No, I really should shut up.
Yeah.
Let's Who told you not to talk, HR?
Puff and stuff?
And weren't we supposed to find out that we got to do some kind of a sex training thing? What are we doing?
We have to learn sex. How to fuck better.
Yeah, they're gonna. Well, HR hires a sex trainer.
Yeah. What's the deal there, Chris?
It's training lasts, I believe, 3 to 4 hours, and we're trying to figure out
how to last for 3 to 4 hours, huh?
It's like
you're supposed to call somebody.
That's you don't know. You're supposed to call somebody. Now, this has to be done every couple of years?
Every couple of years.
Last time I got out of it.
Yeah.
During the Don years.
Yeah.
Now I'm in?
Now you're in. Now we're going to figure out a time and day.
Well, you know what time we work. Yes. Is it going to be during that?
Don't know. That's what I'm trying to...
Could broadcast it. I mean, you know, not it's educational content.
That's not a bad idea.
Some of these, listeners might,
They might be able to use it.
Hey, a little handsy.
All right, so let's move out of company dish and into celebrity dish. That's the drop for celeb dish.
Yeah.
You know, they said Jono went to rehab, but no. They're calling it a wellness retreat.
A wellness retreat because this guy said so upset.
Yeah.
When his show ended.
Yes.
And I guess that he had no real... part.
No prospect. I mean, he spent 7 years of his life
doing nothing.
As Jon Snow. He's not Kit Harington. I mean, it's just even weird. Kit? I mean, does he look like a Kit?
He does not. And I don't. Is he British?
Yes. Yeah. He is.
Listen. Everyone there drinks. Kit, you got to deal with it. You're successful. You don't have to act like your problems are the biggest thing in the world.
Well, they say it has nothing to do with alcohol and nothing to do with drugs. They say he needs a mental health stay.
Can I drop a bomb on you right now?
Please do.
I read some blind items, and you know, these are blind, so you know, take it with a grain of salt. And that cast was doing a shit ton of cocaine.
Really? Mm. Right. Jon Snow.
Yeah, get it. It makes sense.
Looks like winter is coming.
Is he upset that he stabbed his dragon mother?
I mean, if you watched the doc, and I did.
Documentary?
He read the script cold at the table read. So it was the first time. Some people got their scripts ahead of time, but certain actors like to read it for the first time with the group.
Right.
And so there was a camera on his face as he was reacting to the season finale, different things that were happening, particularly what happened with him and Daenerys. And he looked...
I loved her!
It looked devastated. I mean, he looked destroyed.
Huh.
Now, the interesting thing is, I know that the actress who plays Daenerys, she read her script ahead of time, but she also said that she went through, like, a real emotional kind of trauma after seeing the heel turn of her character.
How about when he said this, like when he took off his sunglasses and he goes like, the next dragon you'll see is when we're dragging your corpse off.
And then he danced really weird after that.
Yeah.
A lot of elbows.
Yeah. Throwing bows. I don't know. I just feel like you're making a big deal out of it, dude.
Yeah.
Just go get yourself another fucking job.
Also, you're not Jon Snow. You're Kit.
Look
you're
at me.
Kitty. Kit Snow. You're a little kitten cat.
Guys, look at my face.
Mm-hmm.
Look at it.
Beautiful.
I'm depressed. I need a wellness retreat. I'm not getting one.
Right.
Some of us have, you know, he's got everything.
Dude, yeah, we're having wings delivered, so don't fucking complain.
Yeah.
What time are they getting here, Chris?
Oh, I'm trying to figure out what kind of wings we're getting first.
I would love to send some wings.
Wings are fucking, there's only chicken wings. How's that sound?
Okay.
Don't put any fucking sleazy salsa logo. Got it.
I did like as a child think that the buffalo wings were made out of buffalo meat.
That's adorable.
Yeah. Native Americans used to do that, but not since then.
And they, you know, use the bones for tools and...
they used everything. They made teepees out of skin.
Everything. Yeah. The hide.
Yeah. And then the white man came here and used no part of the meat. Just shot buffalo from a train. Because he was bored.
This is fun.
Yeah.
That was like their video game.
Do you know one out of every three cowboys was black? Girl, look it up. I'm not making that up.
Google it.
I'm watching Deadwood, and those demographics are not reflected.
No, Deadwood is fucking anti-black. It's a fucking complete white paint over, a whitewash, if you will.
I kind of feel like I have to catch back up, because I haven't thought about that show in a long time, and now there's a Deadwood movie.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, there's
comes out on Friday, I think.
Is Calamity Jane in it?
I think it's the whole cast.
Yeah, the whole cast looks like they're back.
Including Hitchcock?
Correct. And, Ian McShane looks exactly the same.
Yeah.
Well, he's in that other fucking show, American Gods.
Yes, yes. I haven't seen it, but I read some of the book, the Neil Gaiman book.
Neil deGrasse Gaiman.
Listen, just because Neil deGrasse Tyson was accused of a few things.
Yeah.
No, it's, I just want to remind everyone he's been accused of a few things.
But never, he's back now.
Yeah.
Right, I saw that they gave him his Nat Geo show back. Now, you know, this seems like a Chris Hardwick situation, more of a, well, we got no evidence, you know?
Right.
Yeah.
Well, that's what Mueller said. We can't, legally, we can't do anything about it.
You know?
All right, so let's move on to the next blind item.
The next blind item is that Britney Spears' former manager, a judge has ruled to extend the restraining order.
Really?
Wow.
Extending restraining order. So, you know, they're placing a lot of blame on her former manager. That he is the reason for the craziness.
Well, it's not, I don't know if he made her crazy, but I think he's been lifting a little money.
Right.
And saying,
but they also say that he has harassed her and her family. Not sexually.
Hey,
you know what they too sitch. But.
You know what they say. This is showbiz. You got to deal with some of these bad apples sometimes.
Is that your Britney Spears impression?
Yeah.
It's so good. It's Thanks. So good.
Thanks. That was her with a shaved head.
I always feel sorry for her. She's like the poor little rich girl, you know? I wish that she had a wellness center that she could go.
I would love for the two of
them
to
And I'd like
to
see her and Kit Snow get together.
That would be amazing. Ooh. Beautiful children.
I don't think he's as good looking as everyone else does. And I also think he's a midget. And he's a terrible actor.
I like his height. I like his hair.
He's 4'10".
He's got a good,
I like it.
He's got a good brow.
He has a great brow, and I look for that in a man.
Like, you can see when he's sad, you know, it, like, really goes up. It's emotive.
Yeah,
and sensitive mouth, too, you know, like,
heavy bottom lip.
Yeah.
Thin top lip.
Yeah. A good bottom lip.
Yeah.
I never liked him.
A kissable lip.
You look like him, Chris.
Oh, thank you.
You look like him. Yeah, you have a kissable lips. Air hose up.
Are you also a bastard?
Asshole. In his own way, I think it is, because you found out that you were more Hasidic Jew and you don't know who it was.
No idea.
I believe it's a father. I think your mom had an
Mazel
affair.
Mazel tov.
Ooh, good for her.
That's possible. Yeah. Like, you have the bastard last name of Chris Queens.
I did a little look into it, and I found that she did, and it was a train, so I can't take a while to find out who inseminated her.
Amy, insatiable.
It's kind of impossible to find out when there's so many men's penises ejaculating at the same time.
See, that's bluntness.
That's the problem.
You guys are wearing the same dad shirts.
That's the kind of dish we need. It's that kind of bluntness.
Let's do a poll on the Instagram, pick a dad shirt.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, will you take a picture of both of them?
I will.
And do you guys want to tie it up to make it like a hat shirt?
Oh, yeah. Like, so you're playing volleyball in the heat.
Let's do it.
No, he's kidding.
Okay. Come on.
I'm not unbuttoning a thing.
Yeah, he's not. That doesn't make sense. Fine. Let's get him away from the TV.
Yeah,
still.
I agree. Let's get you in a more solid. Right here.
I like that you're leaning into each other a little bit, though. It makes you look
titty to titty.
Yeah. They're touching.
Ain't your mama pretty? Got meatballs on her titty. Every day I'm getting to sing that now.
I'm going to say this. Dan, it looks adorable in this picture.
Yeah, he does.
Chris, not so much. This is
what?
Not Chris.
Well, is that strange?
Yeah, it's
strange. As good as you look, I look twice as good. I think the fans will agree.
I hope so.
I am
However, pick based on the shirt, not based on me being better than Chris.
The shirts are shit, but both of you...
I
mean, I think Chris's hair is on fleek.
Yeah.
Ooh, thank you. That's fleek. Good, right?
Wow.
Yeah. It is on fleek. All right. That will be up shortly on the Instagram.
Perfect.
And we can do a poll, right?
Yeah.
Pull it up. In the meantime, please allow me to dish... Adam Levine says he's leaving The Voice after 16 seasons because of rule changes.
Fuck the rules.
I read the article in, I think, Vanity Fair. So here's what happened. He did not have somebody in the finals.
Right. I don't watch The Voice, but I know you have coaches and things like that,
so,
right?
Yeah. Now, he also gets $17 million a year to do this job.
Yeah.
$17 million a year to go, you're good, you're not.
Right. Spin your chair around?
Yeah. The easiest job in the history of fucking show business. Mm-hmm. Now, so he was mad that he had to stand there while everybody else had people. And then he said some mean things about their people. And then the next day were the upfronts for NBC, and they all had to go and sing, and he was just acting like he didn't give a fuck. And NBC said, we want you out. And he's like, I want to go out.
Right.
Because I didn't have anybody in the finals. Now, here's the other problem, though. Is NBC making a giant mistake? Because this guy... If I'm running the failing American Idol, I'm grabbing this fucking dude and get rid of whatever hillbilly or Katy Perry or an undiagnosed fucking judge they have there. You know what I mean? Like that,
scoop him up,
some people over.
And treat him right. You know,
a proven track record and you know a beautiful body.
Yeah. If I was trying to get on his team, I'd sing this. Mm-hmm. There will be love. They will be loved.
Just so you know, I'm flipping my chair around right now for this. And do you turn your chair around when you want someone
when you don't want someone? You
flip, okay.
You turn around and you look at them. And then you're like, oh, they're much fatter and blacker than I thought.
And then you turn.
That's all it is, right? Yeah, yeah. It's just that someone is either fatter or uglier or have a disability that you didn't expect. That's the whole point of the show.
You flip that chair around and then you say, deal. Or no deal.
That's good.
Right. That's
now,
good.
The other day, I wasn't watching TV. I was on my computer, and your mom was watching one of those fucking singing shows. I don't know which one. And I walked over. I'm like, wait, I thought this was going to be an older black woman, not a young white woman.
Right.
And I'm like, oh, that's the whole purpose.
That's the whole point of the show.
And I would have turned around and just thrown up, just projectile vomited.
Oh, my God. The shock alone.
Here's who I think would be good on that show. Me? And Earl. Both of us have a golden ear.
That is true.
And both of us have a biting wit.
You do. You really, really do.
Yeah.
I want to say there's a new one of those shows, but it's for songwriting.
Ooh, nobody can write songs.
That's what I was thinking.
And also, like, wait until someone shows up to write the song.
Yes.
You're just going to do it on the spot?
Yeah. Look, people who are the best songwriters write mainly shitty songs. I mean, you turn around, you look at albums, and you're like, hey, this is a great album. There's two great songs on it.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Exactly. And think about this. People who sell music, they make so many songs, and then their career might be like, I had one or two hits sold.
Right.
And that's like a good career at that point.
Think of people. I was thinking this the other day. Eddie Money was on. He has a TV show that him and his family.
Mm-hmm.
And they travel around and they. I'm like, okay, his first album had two legitimate hits on it, you know what I mean?
Right.
But not top 10 hits even. He never had one top 10 hit. Then he had a couple more radio plays after that. He's still, this is 43 years. And he still can make money off of it. And yeah, there's probably five or six songs that you can think of as Eddie Money songs.
Yeah, I mean, if it only really takes one, and then you've made it.
Certainly there are people still, the fucking Flock of Seagulls guy.
Yeah.
With the Iran song is still touring.
Yeah.
Bald as fuck. He's on a cruise ship with people. Train is doing another cruise ship. How many Train songs can you... I know Soul Sister, I know Drops of Jupiter.
That's all I know.
And then it gets confusing after that.
Yeah, those are the only two I know.
I think that there's a third big one, but
Drive By.
I don't know.
That sounds made up.
That was only in a car commercial.
No,
like,
oh, I sing. You can't even sing it. And these guys are making money. They can fill up an entire cruise.
Yeah.
It's, you know, to be fair, though, it's really more for the buffet.
I guess she's back in the atmosphere. And was like, yeah, finally. Finally, one I know. Drops Jupiter. Hey, yay, yay.
Van Halen is overrated.
Oh, God, Earl. Remember you said that? Earl thought that heaven is overrated was the term Van Halen
is overrated.
It's overrated.
And I believe.
You still have the hook that we can sing?
Yes, I'm pulling it up now.
And by the way, I have no problem saying that this is a great pop song.
It's you can think that you don't like it, but try not singing.
I happen
it's
to
impossible.
Think writing a great pop song is one of the most important things that can happen in the whole world. And it's very, very hard to do. All you got to do is listen to the 80s channel. Seems like you jumped into the middle of the song rather than the beginning. We couldn't find the rhythm, Chris.
Okay, I'll start.
Wait, hold on. Instead of just playing, you gotta take a break. You gotta understand the fucking heartbeat of show business.
Yeah, he'll never make it on The Voice. I know that.
Not only would he wouldn't make it on The Gut.
That really hurts.
I know. You'd think he would.
By the way, it is up. Dad shirt is up and go vote. Is it on story or on the regular?
That'll be on story.
Okay, Chris, easy. Remember
that'll be on story.
Oh, you're gonna fucking talk about yelling, you psychopath.
Sorry. I know my volume gets louder. I'm trying
he
to lean back.
He simply called him a psychopath. And I don't know why.
Chris,
amazing.
Yes,
I have a caller ready to speak in your screen. Okay?
I'm being called out.
Please. Okay. The heartbeat of show business. Where are the wings, by the way?
They're ordered. They're getting picked up now from Blue Ribbon.
Oh no, John in Miami.
Yeah, Train's first big hit was a song called "Meet Virginia." I remember it came out in '99. I wasn't a fan, but it was all over the radio on Long Island.
I do not remember this song.
It's called "Meet Vagina." That's disgusting.
Meet Virginia.
Oh, okay.
Now it's M-E-A-T. Virginia, you know this song, Earl?
No, I don't. I remember calling All Angels. It was another
you looked
hit.
It up.
No.
You looked it up. But yes, I do. That's the third one, Calling All Angels. I know the hook from that. This Meet Virginia?
Yeah.
Smokes pack day. Wait, that's me. But anyway. No, I've never heard this before.
This
in my
fucking
life.
Sucks.
I've never
heard it. God.
Let's chill out, psychopath.
It's like a Sublime song wouldn't make the set list.
That's your favorite fucking band.
Yeah, Chris. You like Sublime like a fucking nerd.
Fucking pussy.
Blue Ribbon shit wings.
What you're doing?
Sublime is for pussies.
We've got
He's
you now,
I'm getting roasted.
That was me machine gunning you.
Please stop yelling at the fucking mic.
Sorry.
How many fucking times have you got this right, fucking
thing? Dude,
can I just say something? This is why I like it.
Was he screaming?
Dude, you're screaming now. I'll fucking pull you.
Maybe if you worked my levels right, you wouldn't have this issue.
I'm fucking running it, you fuck!
I'll sit back here. Is this better? Does this sound better?
It does.
Okay.
Okay, you guys, I've never done
this. Seriously, it's not fun right now. it's turned into this thing that isn't fucking fun, Chris.
The reason I like it is because I know that's what he would yell at guests if he could get away with it. He would yell.
Yeah,
you ever see a very loud guest? You see him just, his jaw is just grinding his jaw.
All right, this is how beloved Chris Stanley is. He's winning on the shirt thing. 66% of the vote.
All right, I know I have some fans in this fan base. So let's show them. Get on your Instagrams, Dan, Disco Dan heads, and prove something.
I just turned your mic off and everyone can still hear you.
That's good.
No, it's not.
By the way, Chris.
Yes.
You don't hate him. There's no reason for you.
There's no reason.
You know, we are still colleagues.
And also, he's a guest on Dan.
Yes, he is a guest. And guest, what do I always tell you? Keep the treat the lowest guests well, so you're not shocked when the highest guests come in, and we won't have the embarrassing thing that we had yesterday with Mike Love. I also got a text from a Mr. Hard Rock Johnny, Disco Dan fan from day one, and he said he can come eat crabs and lift weights with me any day.
Oh, that's Johnny. Awesome! Good Thank job, you. Johnny.
Thanks, buddy.
Big J Okerson says love Dan.
Whoa.
Nice. He's got Jay's
big endorsement.
That's huge.
That surprised me.
Now, everybody, take that and vote on Instagram.
What's that?
Kashmir's eating it today.
See, that's great. This is your real host of Dish, and he's enjoying España right now.
What do they eat in Spain there? Is it like, you know, some, do they eat the bulls after they run them?
Tapas. Yeah, you've been to a Spanish restaurant before, right?
Paella, right? That's Spanish?
Been to a few. Yeah, paella is Spanish, right?
he does know.
I knew.
Truly knows.
I'm looking at this thing. It looks like Chris is still in the lead.
Interesting.
Despite the
Listen, this is a Joe Biden situation. Everyone hates him. It's just name recognition.
I'll take it.
That you is interesting. Me. Because... the question is, who rocks the dad shirt better?
I am the Bernie of this race.
Just
I'm
because
he's the loser?
Shut the fuck up. He's going to win. He will win.
It's a Bernie bro.
He will win.
Two Bernie
he
bros.
He will be mine.
And the least you could do if you will not vote for me in this dad shirt poll is vote for Bernie Sanders for the Democratic nomination for president in 2020.
He won't be alive by the time.
He's not going to make it, dude. Did you see him just crack his head on a shower?
Yeah, that's, yeah, I saw that.
He bathed himself without injury.
The most old Jewish man Band-Aid I've ever seen.
This thing has turned so negative. Let's move on.
Yes, I'm going to move on with the dish.
By the way, Gail. Your dish is the most violent dish.
We've never had a dish where a guest turned on a producer and vice versa.
I'm personally glad he's across the table. I don't want to say anything else, but separate us.
Jeez, this has gotten so tense.
You're threatening me now, Dan.
Would you be better in the other room, Chris?
No, no. Yeah. I want him here so I can dominate him.
Okay. He's dominating.
Yeah, he's weird killing thing. It. At least I'm winning the poll.
The thing that shocks me is that he has the confidence to come into this studio and yell into your mic.
Yeah.
Thing you hate.
Well, everybody knows that Chris is a cuck and a taken.
And for that reason, vote for me in the Instagram poll. On the left.
Look, he's just, this is campaign, you know, this is politics. All right, let's get back to Dish. Lamar Odom is claiming that the owner of the Bunny Ranch tried to kill him in 2015, and that was the reason for his overdose. He claims that he did not consume any drugs, he definitely did not have any cocaine at all, and that he believes that Dennis Hoff was behind this. That it was a poisoning situation, a plot to kill him. And he's, I don't know what he had against me. But he feels like this had nothing to do with him doing any drugs.
I will tell you this. He is a guy who only saying this because Dennis Hoff died. You know what I mean? He had plenty of times to say this story.
Interesting.
There's no one to say anything now.
You feel like... he would not be so bold as to make this claim.
I know one thing. Every time Dennis Hoff came to this place, he went in that window and waved to us with two unattractive women. And every time we just turned around and started talk, we never once wanted him in.
Interesting.
I don't like that whole scene.
It's a strange scene.
So yeah. I saw that Amazon documentary on John Wayne Bobbitt, right?
Mm-hmm.
And in the, I think it was the last episode, Dennis Hoff is in it. And he was like an associate of John Wayne Bobbitt. But I think Bobbitt like threatened to kill him at one point. So they had a falling out. But like, that was the kind of people Dennis was hanging out with, you know, in the late 90s.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I think he hung out with people like that all the time. You know?
Right.
And I don't know whose show he did here. But I never, I even had when I was doing an Unmasked attempt to wave his way in.
That is very strange.
Yeah.
And it was a definite like, hey, I can pop in if you want kind of thing.
Yes. Yeah.
I mean, I can't see that working for most of the Unmasked. You know, I you don't just like insert another person in there.
No, of course not.
But I would say that about most shows of any kind.
Right.
Usually no, but I came in here and it's fine. See? Yeah.
You can come into an Unmasked there anytime you want.
That's true. I'd love to see it.
Sell tickets to an Unmasked, the two of us.
You've actually pwned Chris Stanley today.
Yeah. Wow. I mean, that was a little bit unexpected and not my intention for the dish. I didn't see that coming today. Next dish of the day, and this is actually one of my favorites, is Rob Lowe has a bone to pick with British men. And their appearance, specifically Prince William. He was interviewed and said that it was honestly one of his great traumatic experiences of his life, watching Prince William lose his hair, saying it's going to be an embarrassment that he's going to be the king of, he says, king of fucking England. And he said, let himself go bald.
People go bald. Some people when they're young, some people when they're older, but 95% of people go bald.
Yes. And to act like that this is some sort of an embarrassment of the nation.
Disgusting.
Is really, really bizarre. And the heat in which he was feeling over it, he said, listen, there are drugs out there to stop things like this. And as soon as I had a little bit of feeling, I had it mainlined into my veins. Why wouldn't he do this? He's going to be your king. What a really weird statement. And of course, the Brits are not taking it that well. It's a very strange thing to say. He also said that he feels that British men have low standards for their own fashion and general appearance.
Do you know that the British fashion is considered one of the greatest ever?
Yeah.
The whole thing when I first heard this in business, think Yiddish, dress British. It's considered the conservative style of business. It's not flashy.
Exactly.
It's conservative and it's well done.
And like a well-tailored suit.
Yeah.
You ever see a picture, and I know they didn't have pictures back then. You ever see like a painting of Henry VIII? Dude was fat as shit. Okay. He looked like shit. So, you know.
You're with Rob Lowe 100%. Or is this a way of attacking Chris?
Yeah,
it seems like it's fat shaming. Maybe look in the mirror, Dan.
Wow. Okay. I don't know how to respond to that.
Chris, there's a new sheriff in town. His name is Disco Dan.
I wasn't trying to imply that. I was saying it's fine if royalty looks like shit because it's all about the blood purity.
Right.
Interesting. It's about the bloodline.
Why don't you come up with stuff like that?
Something you wouldn't know anything about.
I never thought about that. I never thought about the incest.
Yeah.
What?
Keeping the bloodline pure is incest. Well,
you said you had Orthodox Jewish blood, right? So incest is probably a part of your lineage.
It's Ashkenazi.
Oh, okay.
Man, Dan is just taking him to the.
I can't
believe it.
Yeah,
yeah,
getting cleaned.
Yeah, I'm taking you, and I'm washing your little dick.
Oh shit! I didn't see it coming.
I didn't see my little dick getting washed by Dan. Is that hand wash? You're gonna cut it off, throw it in the fucking.
He's the Rob Lowe, and you're the Prince William of this show. I'm shocked right now. Nuts.
You seem tired now, like you're beat down.
Oh yeah, he just beat the fuck out of me. He can't seriously take it anymore.
Seriously.
You want me to bring Earl in to handle him?
No,
for you?
No, I don't need Earl.
I'll have Earl pick up your slack because you're tired, you're exhausted, and you're just saying, yes, I am.
I would like Chris to be left in front of me to be flayed.
Well, he already is flayed.
Could he just flay me some more? Just turn me inside.
That's what I'm saying. Oh, I can't. Earl, switch out with Earl. Now, Earl, come in here and fucking work the dozens on him. He's not afraid.
Yeah.
You ready to step out?
Yeah, I'm ready to step out.
There
I'm
goes
out
no moss.
Yeah, oh no moss. God. No moss, everybody. No moss.
You going to keep going?
Yeah, I'm going to keep going.
Right to the street?
Right to the street. I'm going to go talk to Jim.
Why? Because Dan yelled?
Hey, have a seat over here.
I'm done. I quit. I can't do it. I'm done.
You're done
with
the show.
I'm done with the show. I'm done. I can't. I apologize, Chris, to everyone, but I'm done.
Chris, come on.
I'm done. I'm just beat.
Come here.
Please, Chris. Come on, Chris.
Take us to break.
Take us to break.
Bennington Show. Disco Dan has been removed from the studio. Earl's back here. Chris is on the other side of the glass. Everybody's chilling out.
Chill.
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 So chill.
That's sarcastic, yeah. But in a bad place. We never should have Disco Dan in here. Let's face it.
Yeah. I didn't think that. I mean, he's always crazy, Disco Dan. He's always unpredictable.
He pushed it a little bit.
Yeah.
He got a little, you know what? He got a little disrespectful himself. He is the great divider.
And, you know, he's kind of a troll. He is a troll's personality.
Yeah.
It's to be expected with him. But now he's gone. We're chill.
We're all chilling. Earl, are you chill?
Ice cold, baby.
That's too cold.
Yeah. Just chill, please. Not frozen. Like a couple of Fonzies in here.
Yeah. You got to go pump.
I do. But I'm not going to leave just yet. We'll just wait for the chill to take place.
Chill factor.
Yeah. I'd like a nice chill factor.
Could you fix this thing? Earl, thank you. Chris is still winning the dad bod. I think he only went down 2 points since it started.
That is still pretty good. I think that's going to put anyone in a good mood.
Somebody wrote this. Is it me? Or does Dan look like the Pat from the old SNL skit?
I'm starting to think there's not as many Disco Dan heads as he thought there was out there. I know he's calling for them, but it seems like they're not showing up for the polls.
You know who Disco Dan reminds me of? Milo.
This is a Milo situation. Yeah. And you know what you're getting into when you bring Dan into the fold.
Right. Chris, you chill?
Chill.
Scale 1 to 10, how chill are you?
10.
10 being very chill or not chill
very
at all?
Very chill.
Okay.
Boo-doo-doo. Boo-doo-doo. What do I want? Moments on here? No.
Mm-mm. No. Let me do it.
Yeah. But Earl was going to grab it. Refuses. This one.
This one. I got it.
Yeah. Thank you. Hey, Alan, what's up, buddy?
Hey, Ron. Hey, Gail.
Hey.
Hey, so we just finished our harassment training that we do yearly out here in California, and we did it online this time, and it only took an hour, as opposed to having, you know, the talking head come in and, you know, do his little monkey dance in at the front of the the meeting room.
I did do an online one when I first joined the SiriusXM family, and I don't know why we're moving back into the in-person 4-hour block. I've never done it. I
is thought it the really quiz, 4-hour block?
I think it is going to be, it's like a good half day sit down, I think. That's what
that
I've
is
heard.
Incredible.
Yeah. But what I have taken the quizzes.
What a time burn.
Yeah, but you know what? I think I'd rather do that than take the test. Because you could just fuck around on the test and not get right.
Yeah, and the test is actually weirdly time consuming. Like, you can't just like skip through everything. And at one point, I did accidentally answer a question wrong, and I was convinced that I wouldn't be hired after I did it.
Yeah, that happens.
You know, with ours, it was weird because you have to get all the answers correct. So it's if you answer incorrectly, it'll say, "Nerd, try again."
Yeah.
And you go back, you do that, you fill that answer out. And I ended up doing mine in about 45, maybe 50 minutes, and it said, you need to fulfill the time requirement, so go back and reread some of it.
Yes.
And I was sitting there, I had done it, you know, kind of later in the evening. I ended up nodding off and waking up 3 hours later going, oh my God, did I lose the test? And no, it just closed me out, you know, timed out. But
the question I got wrong was, because I was answering too quickly, and I thought, like, I was just, like, trying to get through it. And the question was, is it okay to say, like Peter said to Juanita that she looked stupid with her no hair because she's going through her chemo treatment. Is this okay? And I'm like, yeah, sure, it's fine. And I accidentally hit that. And I was like, okay. I didn't mean to hit that one. That was a misstep.
I can't even pass the BuzzFeed quizzes. I'm always Ross. I don't ever want to be Ross. Tiff in West Virginia.
Hey, Earl, how's it feel watching the crazy from the other side of the table this time?
It was a bit surreal. I mean, I've had my fair share of getting upset.
Can you relate?
Fair share.
I totally relate. Absolutely. But I'm a slow builder, but
we all get that way. We all do it.
But it happens.
But there's nothing but love.
Totally.
Love is good.
Don't say it sarcastically.
That wasn't sarcastic.
What would you like to say?
I love all you guys is what I want
and we
to say.
Love you.
Yeah, and I know that.
We want you to be good.
And I want everyone here to be good.
Seriously, Chris.
Yeah, and I'm being serious too. I'm not being a dick. I'm not.
Sorry about the Dan thing. I'm sorry it got so crazy.
That's Dan, you know?
Not really. I don't know why he was here. All because of fucking the other guys in Spain.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It happens. I've been to Spain. It's crazy out there.
Earl, you love Chris?
Absolutely. Without question.
Gail, you?
Like a brother.
And I love all you guys.
Sometimes we get upset with each other. Doesn't mean there isn't love. There will be love. Sing it, Chris. Strained.
There will be love.
But in the higher. You know what I mean? Yeah. That high thing that you hit perfectly.
There will be love.
That's good.
Perfect.
Earl's grabbing the song right now. It's beautiful.
You know, James Adomian is fighting with the skanks now.
Really?
Yeah.
Brother against brother at this point.
It is. Trump is also just pooning fucking Mueller today. He has every right, though.
That's a beatdown.
Jessica in Philly.
Hi, guys. So I was driving home. I had to stop for gas. I got out. Everything was good. Dan was in the studio. I got back in from filling my car, and now Dan's gone. And what happened? What the fuck just happened?
Dan lights it up, but you know what? It's always stressful to do good radio, and we have to keep an eye, better eye on each other.
Yeah,
I love you, Chris. And I hope everything's good.
This place is stressful on all of us. People don't always know all the stresses. We don't always share all the stresses. We think the other person, sometimes we're protecting them from the stresses. But this is what Big J says to James Adonian, Jim Tews, Louis Dean's Nuts, Natalie Shirley, Brooklyn Ron, Keek in the Cave. You're acting like a queek and a queef and a pussy. I invited you to call me to talk it out, but instead you want to make things up about me saying Creek in the Cave booked our guests. Never happened. Lewis and occasionally I book guests. Your friends vandalized the business of your friend. We all get carried away, Chris.
We do.
I know I do.
We all do.
I want you to be happy every day.
I want everyone here to be happy every day, and I mean that 100%.
Now you're crying, Gail?
No, I'm
because me and Chris don't normally say this kind of stuff to each other.
Yeah.
I'll be very honest. You're the best part of it. This is the best part of my day. It really is.
Well, you say the same thing over and over. No, I mean more if you had something new.
How bad is the rest of your day?
No, like, what's
Chris,
Johnny doing?
Am I wrong if I point that out with him?
He loves saying it.
I know,
says
but
it to
am
me
I not?
I mean it. I mean, I really do.
He does
but
say what
you say
he
it
means.
Differently. I mean, should we get a shirt that said, this is the best part of my day? Bennington? 2 to 5?
Back in the business that I love? What is there not to love? Man, love.
There will be love. I rue the day Disco Dan walked into our fucking happy little love nest. I rue it. Dan started so much trouble.
He's a troublemaker. But he doesn't mean to be, you know what I mean? That's
well,
just...
he does. He does mean that. I mean, let's face it, he's never had a woman or a man since in the whole time we've known him. Why? That goes for you too, Earl. I don't know what's going on there. The best part of your day should be fucking getting up in some, you know? Why isn't it?
I've been asking myself that for a while now.
Why don't you let fucking Chris run your fucking Tinder account like he did for himself?
That's all I ever asked Earl to let them.
Would you allow that? To bring happiness back in?
Yeah. Look at how happy Chris is now.
I'm not sure I'm ready to make that step, but I mean, I've always liked having some degree of, I guess, control over it, but maybe
you don't have
maybe
control, bro. You know what? You gotta let go and let God. That's my fucking motto. Let go and let God. This is the way I live my life. I even do that when I'm driving a car. I let go.
Please
let
don't. God. That's.
I say, Jesus, take the wheel.
I think that's only in emergency situations.
Bum, 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 bum. She will be loved. Kara actually stayed in her cube after clocking out long enough to make sure Chris returned.
That's really sweet that she checked up on him. She's a sweetheart.
Mm-hmm.
And that's got to make you feel good, at least.
And somebody else is saying that they would be willing to kill Dan.
That means people care about you.
Sure it does. Travis. Somebody.
Yes, Bennington.
Okay?
Good morning.
Hey.
How are y'all doing today?
Good, man.
Good. New t-shirt design in commemorating this terrible day but awesome day on Earl's part. There will be love from 3 to 5. Faction Talk 103, Bennington.
Unfortunately, it's 2 to 5, so the first hour is going to be very, very difficult.
It's going to be hate-filled. Chris, you still with us?
I'm still here.
Okay.
Shh. Worried.
No, I'm here. I'm alive.
Just got really quiet, and I thought maybe he left.
No, I'm here.
Okay.
Earl, this is the best part of your day, not Hard Rock?
Hard Rock is a different kind of fun, but this is, you know, radio's the first love. You never forget the first love.
Didn't you say you forgot your first love?
So you never forget your first love. And yeah.
Who was the first girl that you were in love with?
First girl I was? Oh, God. My best friend's sister.
Oh.
Hot.
Social incest. Mm-hmm. Did your best friend know?
I never said it, but everyone kind of knew.
Because mm-hmm. you had a boner on her? Same thing. No. You know, it's more common than you think, dating your friend's sister secretly.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Pretty much exists everywhere in every tribe.
Right.
In the world. You know why?
Why?
We lust for the thing that we see every day.
Mm-hmm. Proximity.
Mm-hmm. That's all it comes down to.
Location.
Lustful and lazy. Yeah.
Location.
Chris, didn't you smell your friend's sister's panties?
I stole them. This was when I believe I was 19 or 20, and I was at a house party, and then I went upstairs to get, and I went through his sister's panty drawer, and I took them.
Did you have them?
What did you?
Eventually.
Yeah. You do the same thing, Earl?
No, I didn't go that far.
You try.
You
Earl.
Jizzed in your friend's fucking boxer shorts.
It must be one of the two, so just say which one.
It was neither.
Did they jizz in your boxer shorts? You still wear boxers?
Yes.
Really?
That
surprises me.
No, briefs are very uncomfortable.
What the about the boxer briefs?
Boxer briefs are extremely comfortable.
Yeah, I feel like that. Why not have that your standard?
You know, but the boxer briefs, boxers are easier to find for some reason. I would prefer boxer briefs.
I feel like you're not looking in the right places. I feel like boxer briefs are everywhere.
Tom, what's up, buddy?
Hey, what's going on? I just want to say I'm a huge fan of Chris ever since the Pepper Hicks days. But I just got to tell him, you can't let Dan get under his skin like that. You got to be a little more thick skin. I mean, come on. It's Disco Dan. Is it really bothering you that much that he's making fun of you?
A lot of wisdom there. I should be more thick-skinned.
I don't know if he's letting it sink in, but yeah. It doesn't hurt to say it.
Oh, you know what? None of us are that thick-skinned. Everybody has a fucking breaking point. And that breaking point is always Disco Dan.
Mm-hmm.
He's a piece of fucking garbage from Garbage Town. And I actually thought I was chilling it so I wouldn't get too angry.
Yeah.
I should just let fucking Chris fucking punch him.
I guess so. I guess that's better.
I should have went over there, fucking treated him like Billy Bats, mm-hmm. fucking rolled him up in a goddamn tablecloth. Chris, I apologize to you.
Thank you. I appreciate
it. We could have been fucking playing that somewhere below the ocean. Chris, you want to come back in here and take your rightful place away from this fucking...
Tippy Tapper.
Cliche who says this is the best part of his day every day?
Sure.
Will you do it? Come back in.
This room special again.
Make this room special. Earl, don't say a word to him.
Just don't even make eye contact because we don't know the state of him. Meanwhile, I'm busting.
Thank you.
Hey. Chris is back in.
I'm back. Back in. Oh.
Let me just say something to you, Chris, and yes. I mean this to the heart. I guess you're back in the atmosphere.
Train, huh?
Chops of Jupiter in your hair. We've all been on edge lately with the fucking Iran crisis.
I know.
The aliens.
North Korea.
Oh, it's the aliens. They're firing. Man. And the aliens.
Everything is. I'm telling you, night after night, I'm having apocalyptic dreams.
Are you really?
Yeah. And horrors and violence in my dreams.
Horrors in your head. Horrors in your bed.
That's a good song. It's really good.
We should all go on the cruise together.
Probably.
I think that would actually really
make
us feel
really good.
They also
said this. They're not like Bon Jovi where they fly in, go on, perform, and then fly out. They stay on the cruise and they do karaoke nights.
That's really great. See, I think this could be something... help with the chill factor. I think that that would be fun for all of us. I think we'd have a good time.
Jay in Mississippi.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
Hey, just go dance a dick. Chris, another man talked about another man's dick.
That's right.
That says something about that man. Don't worry about it. Insecure disco Dan. Insecure. That's all I got.
Gonna have to bury that hatchet eventually.
Right in his fucking neck.
Soul vacation. That's what it would be if we went on this cruise.
Wings are here. That's good.
Hey, Vito.
Hey, Vito.
Hey, everybody. It's Vito.
Vito's here.
It makes everyone feel good.
Yeah. Chicken, you know, blood sugar.
Vito. Chris gets his wings first.
Wings, Vito.
Wings, Vito.
He likes wings.
Tenders. He's a fucking male.
He's an adult male.
Bone in, Vito. Bone in.
I'm not leaving your side, Chris. Even though I'm busting with milk right now. No, I'm literally not going to go.
You should pump.
I want to stay.
Everything is cool. You should
pump. I'm fine.
Everything is going to be great.
Get that milk out.
No, I'm not.
Just draw it out of your breast.
Can I make a recommendation that everybody might like?
Sure.
We get an Airbnb in Jamestown.
That'd be great.
What do you think? You in?
Yeah.
And you know what?
What's that?
And don't take a drink. I want you and Disco Dan to room together.
I mean, it's a lot to ask.
Wrong way.
It's a lot to ask. Maybe.
How is he going to take it?
I mean, you know, maybe.
Literally.
I'll go for same building first. And then maybe move to
room. You
know what?
Yeah. You're going to get your own room.
That's nice. This would be a big Airbnb.
And there's a place to get Indian chickens. In
Look, this is great. Chris skin is.
I mean, cigarettes, not chickens.
I'll take both.
Matt Missouri has a question.
Okay.
Matt.
Hey,
Matt.
I want to ask Earl if his boxer shorts are the one white article of clothing he wears.
Interesting. Are your boxer shorts white?
Black.
First of all, I know that Earl doesn't know things. He doesn't wear boxers. He wears boxer briefs.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Boxers are just too weird.
That's what I was kind of questioning about it, because I would have assumed he looks like a boxer brief guy to me.
Earl doesn't know style, but he wears boxer brief.
I like black clothing and...
That has nothing to do with...
No, but if you were to drop trout right now, would we see a boxer or boxer brief?
Wait, right now I'm wearing boxer briefs.
Yeah. You never wear boxers.
No, I love boxers. I have a pair of boxers. I just
a pair? What color are they?
They're black. It's just harder... Everything... Underwear, black underwear is just hard to find. I found a spot up on 53rd has it.
Eat your chicken, Chris.
I am.
You eat first.
I'm gonna follow like his that. Lead.
You want a little honey to dip in it?
Oh, no, I'm fine. No honey.
Do you have a Coke?
Got some water over here.
Yeah, but would you like a soda?
There's
like,
nice soda here.
Sure. Nice and soda's good, you know? Delicious. Delicious sugary drink.
By the way, whose side are you taking? Are you taking Big J's or everybody that he's lined up against? James Adonian. Jim, too, so I'm very surprised about.
Yeah, that's pretty shocking.
He doesn't seem like a guy who gets some bump.
No, that came out of nowhere. I'll be on Jay's side. Seems everyone's ganging up, you know?
I like that he said you're acting like a queef and a pussy.
a queefy pussy.
He's the pussy and the queef that comes out of it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's kind of what he's sending up.
But he said the queef first.
Mm-hmm.
Which is kind of unusual then to add pussy to that.
That's a little extreme.
I never wanted it to go this far.
No.
It's all Milo. Milo is the disco Dan.
Mm-hmm.
He's the troll king.
Dale in Indiana. Dale.
Hey, Ronnie. How you doing, buddy?
Good, man.
Hey, I just wanted to let you know about a pretty good bed and breakfast up there on the Jamestown area. Just eloped there last month. We had 7 bedrooms in Mayville, New York.
That's beautiful. That could be perfect for us.
Yeah, it's on Jamestown's on the south end of the lake. Mayville's on the north end of the lake. It's like 19 miles from the Comedy Center.
It seems like pretty far.
Yeah, it's way too far.
Now I'm worried that the car ride is going to be more stressful than it's worth.
Yeah.
Paddle the boat.
That's even harder.
Paddling is not what we do. We're motorboat people.
Yeah.
A couple of motorboat sons of bitches over here.
Love it.
Enjoying your chicken?
Loving it.
It's from my favorite place, Blue Ribbon.
Good.
If we break, you want to go bump or you want to wait until after the show?
I'm going to wait until after the show. I would feel more comfortable. Yeah. Not physically comfortable, obviously, but comfortable in life.
All right, let's break. Earl, is that okay with you?
We can break.
Is that okay for the King of Black? Black boxes, black everything.
Very cool.
Thanks, Fabio. Right back, Bennington.
There's a hot wing place downtown that apparently is like the new, like it's been around for a while, but it's one of the original Buffalo spots, and people from Buffalo told me it's better than that place 10 blocks away. This place is called Dan and John's. It's in LES. I'm going to pick that up sometime for everybody because I really want to try it too.
Chris, would you like that?
I would. Yeah, that's fun.
He said he'd pick it up too.
Oh, that's great.
Nice. I biked these back. So, I mean, I could bike food here and back. I'm like Uber Eats now.
You bike today?
I biked the food that I biked to the place and then I biked back
because
I
wanted to. Because you want to work out?
No, because I wanted to get the food back here hot.
Is there something you like to say to Chris today? About the way you feel about him.
Hey, Chris.
Hey, buddy.
Oh, I love you.
It sounded like there was a question mark at the end of that, but I love you.
But he
too.
Means it.
I love you.
I love you.
You know, let's not even worry about the punctuation, dude.
Okay, you're right.
Punctuation comes later.
I'm being a grammar Nazi.
I don't know what that means, because I've only lived through the real Nazis. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people that get called Nazis ain't near what I think Nazis are.
Yeah, grammar Nazi is much less worse than a real Nazi.
You look up in the sky and you see 25 fucking planes flying over. To me, that is living through a war. We're living through a war.
I saw Jeremiah Watkins' stories the other day, and he was said a duck was attacking him. It was actually quite hysterical.
Yeah, he's funny as shit, man.
He's really funny.
He's funny as shit. I know that neither one of you guys was the biggest fan of the wave.
No, and I was against it when it first started.
I was pretty shocked by the wave the first time we saw them. I was confused as to what was happening.
Was it the ladder?
Match was the first time we saw them at What's Your Fucking Deal at JFL, where they ran out with a ladder. One of them jumped off of it, elbow dropped another. I remember one of them was screaming the N-word in people's faces.
That did happen.
It was not getting big laughs.
It wasn't, would imagine. It had everyone a little tense, actually.
Yeah.
Matt, L.A. Matt.
Hello? Yo, hello. I just wanted to say you could tell Vito is really skinny now, or you could tell that he's not as fat as he was just from his voice. He sounds really skinny. He doesn't sound as round anymore.
Interesting.
Like, his face sounds a lot... You could tell his face is, like, skinnier or something. his vocal cords have like got skinnier or something. I don't know.
That is interesting. You don't have as fat of a voice as you used to.
It's interesting, but it's something that you don't bring up in this
They say it's the first place you lose it.
Is in the vocal cords.
Yeah.
Also the first place you gain.
I definitely had a fat voice. I remember my You guys would often say I sounded like I had milk in my throat, and I had to clear my throat, and I didn't have the heart to tell you it was just my fatness.
That was fat you were clearing?
No. Yeah. By saying you don't have the heart, you feel like you were protecting us? How you doing, Chrissy?
I'm good.
Good.
I got everything I need.
You like a bucket of water to put your feet in?
Oh, that's
some Epsom salt? That's what you're asking.
The feet are usually swollen.
I'll do a foot massage.
Yeah, I mean, it's a lot of weight on there.
No, it's hard to come out.
You know what every day we're going to be now, Gail?
What?
Chris Day.
I don't care what it is.
What's tomorrow?
Thursday?
Nope. Chris Day.
All right.
In many ways, it's a Christmas.
That fucking Disco Dan. Matter of fact, nobody say his name anymore.
No.
It's Pisco Pan.
Okay.
Like it's a pan. It's a pan that really hurts.
How's that sound?
Pisco?
Chris Day.
We call ourselves the Christians and like,
dude. And let's Christian. Make the sign of a fish.
All right, okay.
Is that better?
Because he loves fish.
I'm a big fish guy, you know.
PH
and F.
Chris, you like caramel corn?
Yeah,
great. Yeah, fucking Brooklyn out there has caramel corn, and then also Chicago style, which is yellow corn and caramel corn together.
Yeah, the cheesy mixed with the sweet.
Guess what? In Austin, they call that
what?
Austin style.
No, that's not. I think that would really upset the people of Chicago.
True TV, weird because I didn't go to that party, so they fucking wrote to me and said, can we please send you your gift basket?
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it was a fucking neck pillow with a hood.
I've been using the shit out of it.
Where?
I use it to sleep sometimes, and I use it on my flight to Austin and back. I mean, well, no, my flight back from Austin. Rich Voss sat on it on his flight.
Like, because of his asshole?
I guess. I just noticed at the end that he no, I had mine on me, and he goes, I'm sitting on.
I think he was fucking with you.
No, and then the flight, I saw him get up and pick it up as he left.
I am wrong.
Chris, did you get one?
I did not. I got no swag bag.
Maybe you could have Ron's. I mean, I feel like.
No. Okay. Very accurate.
Better times.
Listen to the joy.
Very
in our
accurate.
Voices.
I seem to hear that in the Seinfeld theme.
They're saying that Friends is more popular now in reruns than Seinfeld. And that The Office, The American Office, more popular than both of them.
Yeah.
Yeah. Netflix, The Office, like doubles the Friends numbers.
They're leaving. They're leaving Netflix.
NBC is starting their own like streaming thing, right?
Yeah, I can't keep up with everybody.
I don't want to. You're just paying for like premium cable at this point when you have all of these different things, or you just steal people's passwords.
I don't want a fun future where I'm paying for reruns of TV shows.
Yeah, me either.
I want first run.
Yeah,
fucking movies.
Yeah,
I very rarely want to see a TV show. In the society, yes. Or the town.
That's, I think, no, that. No, it's the town
it's
now.
It's the society.
It's the town now, Chris.
Hey, what's today?
It's Wednesday?
Uh-uh. No. Thursday.
Okay. Oh, I didn't. Okay.
Because the Christians are telling you so.
Right.
Okay, it's the town.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
It's the town of Christians. Earl, could you go with your Baptist church and switch out a picture of Jesus with Chris Stanley? So I know you don't even put him on the cross, right?
No, we do not put him on the cross.
That's bullshit.
That always weirded me out.
I don't know. An empty cross like it never even happened. Ugh.
I remember I bought a crucifix for my mother, and she with Christ on the cross, and she was very upset.
Why?
Because Christ was a white man. They don't want to believe that he was white. Well, we got to get ready to wrap up. What a day we had today, though, huh?
Oh, yeah.
This might have been one of the most stressful Chris days.
Yeah.
Out of the seven possible Chris days.
But they're all good, Chris. Yeah. Every Chris day is good.
GPS Hollywood United Recording Studios that premieres Saturday at 3 p.m. East on Deep Tracks Challenge 27.
You don't have to do that, Chris. Like,
you don't have to do that. Let Vito do it.
Vito, would you do it?
Yeah. GPS Hollywood premieres tomorrow at 3 p.m. East on Deep Tracks Channel 27.
I just did that.
You think this is a good one, Chris?
I think it's a fantastic one. It's great.
You don't have to lie for us.
I'm not lying. I think it's...
There's a 17-year leap in the middle of it.
All great songs, though.
I'll just say this. It's this Chris day. The GPS comes on.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe we could all just write some nice stuff about Chris.
I would like that.
And you know how that dude smoked on the airplane?
Yeah.
I want you to think of the planet as your airplane now. Smoke anytime you want.
That's smoke good. Him, smoke him if you got him.
I'm going to light up.
What do you want in here tomorrow, Chris, to start the show? What kind of surprise?
I don't need any surprises.
Beverage? To your taste?
I'm going to bring a surprise tomorrow. Do you mind?
If you want to, go right ahead, but there's no need to.
Should I wrap it or do I bring it unwrapped?
Unwrapped.
He hates wrapping.
There's no need for this.
This is something I wanted to bring for a while. The fact that tomorrow is Chris Day.
Yeah, that's perfect. That's surprising.
Earl?
Yes.
You get nothing, and you're going to be happy with it.
I think Chris will be happy with it.
I'll take nothing and like it, Ronnie.
Yeah. Jesus. Also, here's an update for you. Disco Dan shit himself, and it's now in his socks. And he is fine with it. He does.
He likes it?
Yeah. He says, finally, his socks fit.
Oh, my God. How loose were those socks?
They were pretty loose. They were jersey loose.
Jesus Christ. How much is he shitting?
Quite a bit. Because it only happens every 3 or 4 days.
Ugh.
It's a bad diet.
That's not
also,
good.
He has
Vito
to
tell you that's not
get
good.
In here very early from Jersey. Very early.
It's the kind of Jersey scum I like, you know?
You would go out with him?
Not after what he did today.
Chris, you're also destroying him 71% to 29%.
See, you know, people...
That's great.
The Chris heads are showing up. The Christians, sorry.
Yeah, the Christians.
The Christians versus the Disco Dan heads. There's not many of them.
This is about a good 30% Disco Dan heads.
Yeah, but
By the way, there's some pictures on Chase thing of some flowers and said that these flowers are cute as shit, want to make an N-word frolic.
Mm.
It's beautiful.
I don't know, Chris.
Oh, no.
I don't want to disagree with you, though.
He said frolic and shit.
This is kind of reminding me of that Twilight Zone where, you know, the kid has control over all the adults and everyone's just doing what they want. That's Chris Day.
That's Chris Day.
Anything you want. You're always right. We love you, Chris Stanley.
Love you, Chris Stanley.
Love you, guys.
Love you.
We love you.
We love you.
We love you.
Love you, too,
Chris.
You
could have told your dad this, Vito, before he was gone?
Love you, Chris Stanley.
Love you, Chris Stanley. See you tomorrow.